intelligence, as we talk about, we can, you know, define in a many, many way. There was a number of ways to define the intelligence, right? So when it's come to the artificial intelligence, so we can think about whether it's a making a computer, which can think, or the automation of any process, who can associate it, like the way we human like to think, the same way if some machine or some automation things can think, it's also artificial intelligence. Or the way human used to do the art and craft thing, right? So if the machine can think and start working on the similar kind of art and craft, that is also part of the artificial intelligence, right? And also the study of the mental faculties through the computer models, that is also artificial intelligence. So the definition of artificial intelligence, I can say it's a very wide, and everyone can have their own definition. But in a very single line, we can say it's the mimic of human intelligence by the machines. When we say machine, the computer, everything comes, it's the machine only. So that's actually the artificial intelligence, where we can replicate our behavior, our way of thinking, our rationally thinking, our decision making. That is actually artificial intelligence, right? So if you want, I can show you one example, and I believe you all are aware about this rock, paper, scissor. Probably you used to play with your kids, or you have heard somewhere. So meanwhile,
in classroom, I used to take AI classes, so I have just make them students learn this game to make them understand what is AI through this game.
Right. So this is the game. It's usually used by the most of the trainers. Like it's something based on the AI tricks, like how the human mind used to think and how we are repeating the, you know, our actions. So by putting this example of, you know, rock, scissor and paper. So if I can choose the rock, probably this system already knows, like I will start from the rock first. So they, and I will repeat the same thing. So on the very repeating actions, he will start acknowledging ki I am having a pattern, and they will start putting the pattern. So this, if you can see how the machines are thinking, they are usually predicting our move. Like we used to repeat ourselves, and basis on the move and the historical data, like I only choose the rock every time. So he used to, if you measure, the machine usually repeat himself in every second or third incident. Right?
Yes.
So this kind of exercise you can check just to, you know, connect the dots between the intelligence, how the machines is working, and how the human brain can be, you know, mimicked by the machines. So in crux, it's something like the system which can think like human, which can react like human, and which can act like the human. So in real life also, we are having a multiple examples related to this on the AI, which we will cover, of course. But the very famous, which used to be taken care or given by everyone, which is connected in our life, it's something Google Assistant, Siri or Alexa. And I'm sure like you guys have tried multiple times.
Of course.
Yes. In case you tried the WhatsApp also, by the voice recognition, rather than writing any text, you're supposed to tell him so that it can convert your voice to text. So that is also part of the AI. So we will cover this all, how they are working, right? So now how to check whether the machine is actually or working like the human, whether there is a artificial intelligence is implemented or not. So this kind of test is known as a tuning test. This tuning test was, you know, firstly identified and implemented in the 1950. So the principle of this test, the art of creating machine that perform functions which required the intelligence, which supposed to be performed by the people. That means where the replication of human action, human mind and human performance is getting replicated by any machine or any of the system is actually the artificial intelligence. And the study related to this particular thing is actually artificial intelligence. right? So this tuning test, you will you can go in a detail. It's a very, very long process and which is still applicable. Since 1950, it was followed by the all the developer who's working on the AI. Now, why we need the AI? Any thought? Like, we are having a plenty of human resources available, and being on India, we are the one of the very high human resource capable country. So why we required the AI?
So there are certain tasks which could not be performed, by which are dangerous for humans. There we can use AI, as well as error is reduced. Human error, like we do, machines are designed in such a way that they are not emotionally, actually, they are not biased. So all these things may, we require this AI for all these things.
And sometimes we need to do something repeatedly, which is, you know, not possible for the humans. They get bored of doing
tired
again and again, and they get tired also. So it's that is the reason. Yeah.
And machine can do it quickly as compared to human beings. They take very less time.
Right, you all are correct. So there is a one point, the fairness, another point, the safety measures, another point, the boredom or the repeated task, which human brain got the bore with the same thing. If you follow the same pattern every day, you usually want to change, right? So exactly the requirement of AI is the same. So that we can make the machine which can function fast, more accurately than the human. Like someone said, like the to avoid the error and the correction, to match the accuracy also, right? And also the same repetitive task can be done by the machine. So what you said is the exactly requirement of the AI, which thinks our developer to work, focus and convert the things so that human can have their quality of time and they can spend the quality of times in the some other things and other tasks. So that is the exactly requirement. And the AI, we can use for the multiple things, as already explained by you guys, right? The first thing is the safety, where the risk is involved. You are correct. To avoid, like, human life is more precious than anything else. So we can have the machines to perform the task where the human life usually got in a danger. The things which perform with the accuracy and the speed, so that we can maintain this. The things where the human supposed to get tired and where the more power and the more things are required, so we can get that power from the machines. The accuracy is the one part. And also to overcome the human inefficiency. When we said the human inefficiency, it's not mean by the capability, it's mean by the human nature. Right, psychologically sometimes the things are getting the efficiency got degraded, maybe the repeated task or maybe the something else, right? So to overcome such things where the, you know, the emotional part, the hardcore emotional things are about to come, and also to achieve the consistency, right? And we can have the machine as the companions also, and where who can understand the function and can involve. So this is exactly requirement where we can implement, and we guys are implementing. So many things are already achieved in the AI. So now coming on the AI capability and the applications. So I am just touching few of them. There was a number of AI abilities and the applications where it's going, but I am touching the few of them which are very popular and which we used to have. If you remember, I given you one example of the WhatsApp text to voice to text, or the similar kind of Alexa app, or something related to the app, or something machine where the natural language processing is required. So the machines where they have progress in learning the natural language processing. The natural language processing, like if I'm having a software which convert voice to text, and probably whatever I'm talking to you, it's getting documented on the another machine, where they are appropriately choosing all the spelling as well as the punctuations also on the basis of my language, which is the natural language which I am using. So one is the application where we can use for the language. Second, we can use the AI machine for the recognition. And this is something which nowadays getting implemented everywhere. The recognition, a machine who can recognize the human facial on the basis of the facial, who can identify the gender, age group, ethnicity, and the emotions, also the facial expressions. The machine can understand where the expression is a tireless or whereas someone is actually in an emergency or required some support. The third, on the vision part, right? So let's say we can identify and we can differentiate between the any of the pictures by looking at whether the picture of a tree or picture of a dog, picture of such animals, or by looking at the object. But the same capabilities, if we are transferring to the AI, right? So AI can become the same capable to identify all the difference by the computer visions. Like it can get identified difference between the objects. And the best example you can choose, if you guys tried ever the Google Lens. It's one app, Google Lens, and probably that if you select that app and you can choose any of the object, it can identify it, whether it's the laptop or it's something else, and related search can be shown.
So it is there in the, sorry to interrupt, it is there in the mobile phones as well. Like if you will, click any picture. So if the picture is of a dog, so it will tell you that this is a dog or a cat. So this, I have this feature in my phone.
Right. So that's the recognition method. And if you remember, probably on the Facebook also, the same algorithm is used whenever the picture was uploaded and Facebook suggested you your friend's name, whether in your picture is someone is around you that suggests the name. So that is also used, the same facial recognition algorithm used by the Facebook also. Now on the navigation, AI machine can get a progress in the learning of the self navigation so that they can sense about the route and everything, right? So the best example is a self-driven car, which is the hottest thing nowadays in the market. And probably you heard about the Tesla, who's getting successful because of this self-driven cars. Also on the gaming part, the machines can replace the human, become your companion to play the games also. And as we discussed in the last, the creativity part also. So there was a machines who can write the stories basis on, if you are giving you the some clues or the plot, they can write a story, they can make a painting, and even the music is also getting created by the AI nowadays. So probably in the coming years, you will heard in place of any composer, there might be some company's name who's doing the composing of music.